Good evening, boys. In my previous lecture, I have just stated the electric dipole and its definition, the nature of the quantity, the unit, and the dimension. Now we are going to find out the electric field on an axial point due to an electric dipole. Axial point is that point which lies on the axis joining the negative charge and positive charge. Let this point P is at a distance r from the center of the dipole, that this is the center of the dipole, and this distance is r. Now the length of the dipole is 2a, this is minus q, this is plus q. E plus has been marked as electric field due to plus q charge at this point P, and E minus has been marked, that is electric field due to minus q charge at this point P. You know that electric field is always directed away from the positive charge and is directed towards negative charge. That's why the direction of E plus is in this direction and the direction of E minus is towards negative charge, that is E minus in this direction. First of all, we will write the magnitude of E plus and E minus. Just see here, E plus, that is electric field due to plus Q charges, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by, and now for R, the distance of this point P from this charge plus Q, this distance is R, this length is A, then you can write that is R minus A whole square. This is equation 1. Now for E minus, it is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R plus A whole square. This is equation 2. Now we have taken here as R plus A, it is R distance up to this point and A distance this one. So this is R plus A and this is R minus A. Now these two electric fields are anti-parallel to each other. These two electric fields are anti-parallel to each other. So the net electric field will be the difference of these two fields. That is E net electric field E is equal to E plus minus of E minus, which is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q in bracket 1 upon R minus A whole square minus 1 upon R plus A whole square. We have taken this common. Now, for the next calculation, that is, we can take, that is, E is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught. LCM is R minus A whole square, R plus A whole square, and this is R plus A whole square minus R minus A whole square. Now here, if you square these two terms, that is R square plus A square plus 2AR, and in this R square plus A square minus 2AR. Now solving this, you can get E is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught, this is 4AR upon R square minus A square whole square. So that is in the form of A minus B into A plus B. You can write this R minus A into R plus A whole square, that is R square minus A square whole square. Now for next calculation, we can rub at this point, because you must have noted it. Now E is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught 4AR upon R square minus A square whole square. Now you can write this term in 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into 2 times q into 2a into r upon r square minus a square whole square. Now this quantity q into 2a, so you can see that this is equal to this. Q into 2a gives a dipole moment p, and we can write this expression in terms of dipole moment, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 pr upon r square minus a square whole square. Again, we can rub at this point, and we can proceed further. That is, E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 pr upon r square minus a square. This is the general formula without approximation. That is, the electric field at an axial point of the electric dipole at point P at distance r from the center of the dipole. Now, for approximation, that is case 1, that is r much greater than a. If the distance of the point from the center of dipole is greater than, much greater than half length of the dipole, then we can write this expression using simple mathematics, that is 2pr upon r power 4 in bracket 1 minus a square upon r square whole square. Now, if r is much greater than a, then 1 is much greater than a by r. Or you can say a by r is much less than 1. Certainly a by r whole square is much greater than 1. That's why this quantity can be neglected, and we can write E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by r cube. Because r and r can be cancelled. And this is the final expression for the electric field on the equatorial point, axial point of electric dipole, and the direction of the net field is in the direction of E plus. Or you can say the direction of dipole moment P is in this direction. So E and P are in the same direction at this point P. So in vector form, you can write E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p, both in terms of vectors, upon r cube. So this is one of the approximation methods what we have used, and the logic behind this approximation is given here. You can just bifurcate this point and you can note it down. If r much greater than a, 1 much greater than a by r, or you can say a by r much less than 1, and squaring it becomes again much and much less than 1. That's why this quantity can be neglected with respect to 1. And 1 square is 1. So we can proceed further. So this is the electric field on the axial point of electric dipole. For example, we can take a simple question based on electric dipole to find out the electric field on the axial point of the electric dipole. Now, we are taking question in short notation, that is r is equal to 2 meter, q is equal to 4 microcoulomb plus minus 4 microcoulomb, and the length of dipole, that is 2a, is equal to 2 millimeter. Now, I am giving one question for you, that by using this data, use two formulas to obtain electric field, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 pr upon r square minus a square whole square, and second one with approximation 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by r cube. This is equation 1 and this is 2, because r is given, a is given, q is given, and a here, if p is given, then certainly you need the value of 2a for calculating the value of p. Now you have to find out the electric field at same point p by these two expressions, and please let me know the difference on the WhatsApp. I want to know the difference, and then I will explain the cause of that difference. Now you can calculate directly, because this r, that is 2m, 2 meter, and 2 meter, 1 meter is equal to what? 1000 millimeters, that is 2000 millimeters, and here it is 2 millimeter. So 2000 millimeter is much greater than 2 millimeter, so we can directly use this formula, that is E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 q into 2a upon r cube. Now all the values are given, you can write, this is 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 2 into value of q, that is 4 into 10 power minus 6 into the value of 2a. Here it is 2a, that is 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter upon r cube, that is value of r is 2 meters, that is 2q. It is Newton per Coulomb. Now you can perform this calculation and you can get the result, and this electric field is directed in the direction of dipole moment P, which is directed from minus Q to plus Q. Clear? Now our next topic is the electric field on the equatorial point. So we can calculate the value of electric field on the equatorial point, and equatorial point is also called broadside on position. Equatorial point is also called broadside on position, and axial point is also called end on position. End on position. Now, electric field, on equatorial point. An equatorial point is that point which lies on the perpendicular bisector of the electric dipole. It lies on the line on the perpendicular bisector of the electric dipole. Now if we draw the figure, here it is minus q, here it is plus q. The length of the dipole is 2a. From the center, we have, this is central point, we have taken distance r. Now these are two lines which are being drawn. This is minus q, this is point p. Now you know that the electric field at point p due to plus q charge is directed away from the discharge, that is E plus, and electric field due to minus q charge is E minus. Here it is a horizontal line. Let this angle is theta. This angle is theta, because this is isosceles triangle. Again, this angle is theta and this angle is theta. Now we resolve, as you have seen in the case of forces, we resolve the electric fields in two mutually perpendicular directions. That is, in horizontal direction and in vertical direction. Now, if you find the component, this is E plus cos theta, this is E plus sine theta. Sin theta, again for E minus, this is E minus cos theta in this direction, and again here on this line we have E minus sin theta. you can draw this figure clearly. Now, you know that magnitude of E plus is equal to magnitude of E minus, which is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon. Now, what is R? R is this length and this length. You know that is this point AB and this point is P. Then we can say that it is AP square, length of AP square, which is equal to R square plus A square, because this distance is what? A. This distance is A. Now, you can write here as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square plus A square, because it will be square root, and square of square root is again that quantity. So R square plus A square. This is magnitude of E plus is equal to E minus. Now, you can see here that E plus sine theta is directed upward and E minus sine theta is directed downward. And the magnitude of E plus is equal to E minus. So vertical components cancel out. Vertical components cancel out. That is net electric field in y direction is equal to E plus sine theta minus E minus sine theta is equal to 0, since E plus is equal to E minus. Magnitudes are same. So net electric field at P is due to horizontal components that is E plus cos theta and E minus cos theta. Clear? So we can write net E is equal to E plus cos theta plus E minus cos theta, and we know that E plus is equal to E minus, so directly we can write E is equal to twice E plus cos theta. Now we have to put different values and we can get the net electric field at point P due to an electric dipole on an equatorial point or on a broadside on position. So again we can rub this, and using this expression again that is E is equal to twice E plus cos theta, that is E is equal to twice E plus, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square plus A square into cos theta. Cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. Base is A upon hypotenuse, that is AP. And AP is equal to what? A square plus R square to the power 1 by 2. In similarity form you can write, because here it is R square plus A square, R square plus A square 1 by 2. Now combining these two terms we can write 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 QA upon R square plus A square whole to the power 3 by 2. And this quantity can be considered as dipole moment P, 2QA, dipole moment P. So we can write this expression as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P by R square plus A square whole 3 by 2. Now this is expression without approximation. And now for approximation, that is R much greater than A, that is distance of the equatorial point P from the center of the electric dipole is much greater than half the length of electric dipole. So we can use this approximation as E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P upon, we can take this R square outside. If we take R square outside, then first it meets with square root, then it becomes R, then it meets with Q, then it becomes R cube 1 plus a square upon r square whole 3 by 2. Now you know that, as I have given the explanation, that is, if r is much greater than a, then a by r is much less than 1, then a square upon r square is again much, much, much less than 1. So it can be neglected in comparison to 1. That's why we can write this expression as e is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught p upon r cube. P upon r cube, r in vector form e is equal to minus times 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught p upon r cube. That is, this minus sign indicates what? This minus sign indicates, that is, both vectors e and p are antiparallel. The direction of p is what? The direction of p is from minus q to plus q, minus q to plus q. And the direction of E's net electric field is in this direction. So this is the net electric field and this is the dipole moment P. You know that these are anti-parallel to each other. And if they are anti-parallel, then suddenly we will place a minus sign here and E is equal to minus times 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube. So you have obtained the electric field due to electric dipole on the axial point and on equatorial point. And you have seen the difference, that is, electric field on the axial point is twice the electric field on the equatorial point for same value of R and A. That is, if charge Q remains same, means if the dipole is same, then the electric field at an axial point at a distance r from the center of the dipole is twice the electric field at a distance r on an equatorial point, but the direction of the field on the equatorial point is negative, that is opposite to the direction of dipole moment p, and on the axial point the direction of electric field and the direction of dipole moment p both are parallel to each other, so there exists a positive sign. Now comes the turn of ideal dipole. Ideal dipole. Ideal electric dipole is that electric dipole whose charges, whose magnitude of the charges tends to infinite and the separation between the two charges tends to zero. That is, the distance between the two charges can be as much as small and the magnitude of the charges can be as large as can be. So the ideal dipole, because in sometimes it is asked in board that what is the condition for electric dipole. The condition for electric dipole is, that is, magnitude of the charges should be maximum or tends to infinite and the separation between the charges should be minimum or it tends to zero. So this was all about the electric dipole, electric field due to electric dipole. Now for the potential due to electric dipole, we will do this topic when we will read potential. But question assignment and the work for you is, that is, one thing. First, prepare the derivations of electric dipole. Second, frame two questions each for axial and equatorial point. And third is, properties of electric lines of force force. Fourth, electric field lines, due to different charge distributions. Now, if you have any problem, then directly you can ask your questions on YouTube channel, and you can ask your questions on the group which we have made. And if you feel shy while asking questions in the group, you can ask your questions personally on my number, either by giving in the form of text, or you can directly call me. But if you are calling, then please call me during the daytime, that is between 10 and 1. That is 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Thanks. Have a good day.